Gracious and Heavenly Father, if only we give a chance to the one who created the heaven and earth, if only we come to you seeking your forgiveness, seeking for that healing touch, seeking that transformation, you are more than willing to walk into our lives and change and transform each one of us for eternity. As we have gathered together at your feet, Lord, speak to each one of us that we may find your will, that we may follow your footprints, that we may please you, that we may glorify your name. Speak to your servant, and through your servant, speak to each one of us. In Jesus' name, Amen. Friends, can you turn your Bibles to Book of Ruth, chapter 1, first chapter. Book of Ruth, first chapter. Until the end. 16 till 22nd. Let's all read together. But Ruth replied, "Don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, will I go. Where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me." When Naomi realized that Ruth determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. So the two women went on until they came to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, the whole town was tired because of them. And the women exclaimed, "Can this be Naomi?" "Don't call me Naomi," she told them, "call me Mara, because the Almighty has made my life very bitter. I went away full, but the Lord has brought me back empty. Why call me Naomi? The Lord has afflicted me. The Almighty has brought misfortune upon me." So Naomi returned from Moab accompanied by Ruth the Moabite, or Moabitess, her daughter-in-law, arriving in Bethlehem as the barley harvest was beginning. Dear friends, this evening I would like to title this sermon, Better or Bitter? The title of this sermon is Better or Bitter. Naomi, for some reason, she never wanted Orpah and Ruth to follow her. And she spoke to them saying that you go back to your people, you go back to your parents, you go back to your gods, the gods of Moabite, or heathen. They can never transform lives. They can never solve the problems of life. They can never help anyone who is in need. And here there are two women, three widows, struggling for life. There is no one to take care of them. Their lives were so barren. And they need God.
And Naomi knows that God is the Almighty God is Jehovah. And she would have taken, as she should have taken, the situation and an advantage to speak about living God. She should have taken this situation to explain about God's goodness, because she heard that God visited His people and He prospered them. He provided to each one of them by visiting them. And Naomi should have taken that news as an instrument to share the good news about God. But she failed. Though she knows about God, but then she was not willing to speak about God. Do you know why? She herself is away from God for more than 10 years. Whoever lives away from God cannot witness God or witness for God. Whoever displeases God and disobeys God cannot speak for God. They cannot tell the goodness about God because they themselves are not in good position and good shape. Frankly speaking, do you know why you don't speak about God? Don't be offended if you listen to this. It is just simple statement that you don't have right relationship with God. And that's the reason you don't feel like speak about your God. You yourself is not finding what God wants in your life. You yourself could not find the connection with the Creator. That's the reason you're unable to speak about the Creator to those who are lost. Naomi was living away from God for more than 10 years. And her family was ruined. She lost husband. She lost children. And she herself became barren. And she's away from God for more than 10 years. How can she speak about God who is Almighty? And beside that, she wanted these two daughters-in-laws to go back to their people, parents, and their practices, which is so sad. And Naomi should have been an instrument to win these souls. And Naomi should have been an instrument to bring these people to God. But then she was driving them away from God. And finally, Orpah, she gave up. She went back to her parents and she went back to her former practices, worshipping the creation than the Creator. Why? Because of Naomi, the one who was a lukewarm believer in God. She herself gone away from God. Now, because of her, one soul was lost eternally. She looked at Ruth and said, come on, you also go along with your sister. As she went to her parents, as she went back to her practices, go back. But Ruth determined in her heart never to turn back until she finds who is this God. And she said, don't urge me. She said, don't force me. I have decided to follow you. I have decided to know your God. Your people are my people. Your place is my place. Your God is my God. Only death can separate us. Until then, I will not leave you. Whatever choose women. బాబు కొంచెం సెల్ ఫోన్ ఆఫ్ చేసి పెడతావు నాయన, ఫ్రంట్ కూర్చుని ఆన్ పెడితే ఎట్లాగా? బహుశా ఫస్ట్ పర్సన్ నువ్వు 13 ఇయర్స్లో ఎప్పుడు చెప్పలే సెల్ ఫోన్ ఆఫ్ చేయమని చెప్పి. మొత్తం బ్యాటరీ తీసేసావా? గొడవ వదిలిపోయింది. రూల్స్ విమెన్ who takes a decision and stands on it. And she said, I will not go back.
I'll come with you. My mother-in-law, I will not leave you till we die. What a wonderful person she is. You and I will stay together. The Bible says they walked together until they reached the destiny called Bethlehem. They walked together. How many mother-in-laws and how many daughter-in-laws can walk together, talk together, live together? Very few. But if you find a mother-in-law and a daughter-in-law live together, walk together, talk together, and believe the same God together, I tell you, dear brothers and sisters, they'll make wonders, a wonderful family. How can I say that? Because I can see in the life of Ruth and Naomi. And Ruth said, don't ask me to go back. The reason is, I have determined in my life, in my heart, no going back, no going back, no turning back. And finally the Bible says, Naomi stopped insisting her, stopped talking to her regarding going back. Then now they have come to Bethlehem. Let's see what happened. After 10 years, more than 10 years, Naomi returned to Bethlehem. And see how people addressed her, how people reacted to her. But the Ruth's 17th verse, or 19th verse. So the two women went on until they came to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, the whole town was tired because of them. And the women exclaimed, can this be Naomi? People from Bethlehem, they all came together and they started discussing about these women who entered into the city or the town of Bethlehem. Nobody came forward and said, you're Naomi. No. Naomi, how are you? No. Where have you been all these years? No. They were discussing within themselves, saying that, is this Naomi? Why? Why they couldn't come to her and greet her directly, saying that, Naomi, how are you? Do you know why? Because she lost her beauty. When you live away from God, it affects not only on your spiritual life, it also affects on your physical life. It also affects on your face, on your beauty. People could not recognize Naomi when she came back. That's the reason they were discussing. She lost her beauty. I know one of my relative who was a very handsome man. Very, very, very handsome man. People loved him. Not only he was an handsome man, he was also a kind man. But unfortunately, somewhere in the world he got addicted to the drugs. As he was addicted to drugs, he lost his health. He lost his beauty. And finally, he came to a place where people could not recognize him. Dear brothers and sisters, sin brings pleasure. At the same time, sin takes away your beauty. Sin takes away your peace. Sin takes away your personality. Sin takes away your position, and sin takes away your passion for God. If you look at these pictures, you will understand how their faces have turned. Look at the left photo, of left to my side. And look at the other photo, how he lost that shape, that beauty. And look at these women. Can you imagine?
and look at this person. And what you see in these people, they were so beautiful, but then something happened, they lost their beauty. When Naomi went away from God, she lost her beauty. Dear brothers and sisters, don't go too far from God. That will affect your entire life. There are many young girls and boys, they lost their education because of their sinful practice. They lost their jobs because of the stupid things that they have done. They have lost their health. They have lost their relationship with their parents and friends and relatives. And they have lost their health and beauty. They cannot even survive without using money. Without using medicine. Even though they use medicine, and yet they are not strong enough to face the days. Is there anybody this evening that you are at the edge of losing what God gave to you? People are unable to recognize you because you lost your health. And you lost your health because of those things which you have done against God. And things that you have done within your body has spoiled your health and spoiled your beauty. When people came and said, is this Naomi? Friends, do you know what Naomi said? See what she said. Look at the reaction of Naomi. Don't call me Naomi. Look at the way that she's answering. Don't call me Naomi. She told them, call me Mara. Call me Mara. Don't call me Naomi. Naomi means, in English, it is pleasant, delight, joyful. These are the meanings from Naomi, the name of Naomi. Don't call me Naomi. Call me Mara. Mara means bitter. I lost my joy. I lost my delight. I went from this place with everything. See what she says. 21st verse. I went away full. I went away full. But the Lord has brought me back empty. When she said, I went away from this place full, that it doesn't indicate that she went from that place as a rich woman. But that does say that she went from this place as a complete woman. Full means, complete means, husband and children. I went from this place with my husband, with my children. But today, I came back. Empty. What does it mean by that? Without my husband, without my children, my life is not complete. Dear brothers and sisters, now she realized the importance of husband. Now she realized the importance of children. We do not know in what way, what manner husband died and the children died. I do believe that they did not die because of an accident. But I believe that they might have died because of sickness. When husband died, at least she should have turned to God seeking help. Lord, Lord, have mercy upon my husband. Please save my husband. He is on the deathbed. He is at the edge of losing his life. Lord, we are so sorry that we left you, we came to this place. But now I am about to lose my husband. Please, please save my husband. No. For some reason, many women don't pray for their husbands. Is that right in your life? For some reason, many men don't pray for the well-being of their wives. Is it true in your life? Let me tell you this. Many times, many people come to me asking me to pray for their needs. One sister came to me and told me, "Brother, will you please pray for my father because he's struggling with a financial crisis?" I said, "Yes, I will." "Brother, one more thing. Will you please pray for my mother? She's suffering with sickness." I said, "Yes." "Brother, please, will you pray for my brother because he's struggling without job?" I said, "Yes." "Not only that, brother, will you please pray for my sister because she's not married and she's not getting married for a long time?" I said, "Okay, I'll pray." "Finally, brother, will you please pray for my children because they need good education?" I said, "Okay, I'll pray." And immediately she closed her eyes. Then I asked her, "How about your husband? Is he still alive?" Then she says, yes, my husband is alive." "And why didn't you ask me about your husband too? Why didn't you ask me to pray about your husband? Why didn't you ask me to pray for your husband?" She forgot. For some reason, unfortunate husbands don't even deserve the prayers from their wives. Why is this? Naomi, you should have sought God's help when your husband was about to die. No, she didn't turn to God. Husband died. Then she realized the importance of husband. Many husbands don't understand the importance of wives until they die. Many wives don't understand the importance of their husbands until they die. Recently, one gentleman came to me and he was so sad. And he spoke to me saying that, "Now I feel empty." I said, "Why?" "As long as my wife was alive, I never felt that emptiness in my heart. And I know her wife suffered long time. She suffered sickness for a long time. And she was bedridden for a long time. I know his wife suffered for a long time and bedridden for a long time. She couldn't cook for him. She couldn't take care of him. All the time he was taking care of the wife. But she died." I said, "Even if your wife lived, she couldn't serve you, she couldn't take care of you, she couldn't even prepare food for you. You are the one who is doing everything for your wife." Do you know what husband said? Do you know what that gentleman said? "Even though my wife could not cook for me, take care of my needs, but as long as she was alive, I was a complete man. But when my wife died, I'm unable to tolerate this emptiness, the loneliness." Then I said, "I know that you are blessed with your children. You are blessed with children. You got your children. Why do you still feel you're empty and lonely?" Then he said, "Children are children. They can never compensate wife and wife's love." Dear friends, he could only understand the importance of his wife only after her death. Is there anybody waiting for that day? Na pellam jaste anta baagunna unnara man madhya evaraina alanti vaallu na mogudu chaste anta baagunna anetatuvanti vaallu unnara chachin tarvata telustundi vaallu viluve emito batukunu matram em chesadu em sadinchadu batukunu matram em chesindi ఏమి చేసినా చేయకపోయినా భర్త భర్తే భార్య భార్య ఏమిటి నేను తెలుగు భాషలో మాట్లాడుతున్నాను మీకు అర్థం కావాలని నయోమి సేస్ నౌ ఐ లెఫ్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ప్లేస్ విత్ మై హస్బెండ్ అండ్ టూ చిల్డ్రన్ ఐ వాజ్ కంప్లీట్ విమెన్ బట్ నౌ ఐ కేమ్ బ్యాక్ ఎంప్టీ డియర్ బ్రదర్స్ అండ్ సిస్టర్స్ వాల్యూ యువర్ హస్బెండ్ వాల్యూ యువర్ వైఫ్ You'll only realize how important they are when you see
or when you experience that loneliness. But before that happens, be a nice husband and be a nice woman. Be a nice wife. At least she should have come to God in repentance after she lost her husband. And she didn't do that. She waited and wasted time. What was the result? She lost elder son. Husband, elder son. At least then she should have repented and turned back to God. No, she didn't turn back to God. Then what happened? She lost her second son. Dear brothers and sisters, don't wait until you lose everything in your life. Don't wait until you lose everyone in your life. Come back to God. Seek His help. Rectify your mistakes. Repent of your sins. And follow the instructions of God for better life. But unfortunately, Naomi waited until she lost everything. But now she complains against God. She says, it's all because of God. Is it because of God? No, my friends. It is not because of God. It is because of her foolishness. It is because of her husband's foolishness and foolish decision. But now she blames God for all that is happening in her family. There are many people, when they go through problems, when they go through tough times, when they go through a bad situation, do you know what they do? They blame people around them. When things go wrong, they blame God. There are many people even in front of me. Maybe you are blaming God for things that are happening in your life, in your job, in your business, in your family, in your education. You are blaming God. Saying that, where is God? What is He doing for me? Or what has He done for me? Nothing. No job, no promotion, no project, no visa, no marriage. No children, no happiness, no joy, no health. It's all because He's not granting unto me. How dare you blame God? Look at this woman. She blamed God for more than three times. Three times. Repeatedly, repeatedly she said, it's because of God. Let us read once again. 20th verse. Don't call me Naomi, she told them. Call me Mara, because the Almighty has made my life very bitter. I've gone through bitter experience. It's because of God. No. Is there anybody this evening that you are going through a bitter experience? Bitter experience in your exams. Bitter experience in your interviews. Bitter experience in your job. Bitter experience in your married life. Bitter experience in relationship, in friendship. Bitter experience in your job or in your business. And you are going through those bitter experiences because of your foolishness and because of your wrong decisions and because of your wrong steps. And yet you blame God. Why? How can you expect right way of thinking from a person who lived so long away from God? She was a woman, lived away from God more than 10 years. And look at the language that she was using it. Look at the way that she was speaking. She was blaming God. The language is not correct, not good. What she's speaking is not good. Yes, those who live away from God, they cannot speak properly. Those who live away from God, they cannot speak truthfully. Those who live away from God, they cannot even speak rightly. Look at Naomi, what she says. It is God who turned my life bitter. Don't call me Naomi. Call me Mara. The second thing. I went away full, but the Lord has brought me back empty. Dear friends, let me tell you this. She went from God as a complete woman.
But she went from God to the world. She went from God into the world with husband, with children, maybe with some money. But now she came back to God as an empty person. That is what happens most of the times, dear brothers and sisters. When you are full, when you are complete, when you have everything, when you have job, when you go through success, when you go through prosperity, do you know who takes you away from God? The devil. When she was full, she went away from God to the place where she will never find godly people, to the place where she will never find godliness, to the place where she can never find a place to worship God. It was a heathen place. She went away from God to the wrong place. And now she came back to God, saying that I came back to God empty. But let me tell this way. Let me put it this way. And she says, God brought me back as empty person. It was not God who made her empty. It was her foolish decision that made her life miserable and empty. Now God brought her an empty life. Do you know why God brought her back as an empty person? Dear friends, let me ask you this question. How many of you wants to have a wallet full of money? Can I see your hands? A wallet with money. Can I see your hands? Amma, how about you? How many of you would like to have your bag with money? Can I see your hands? ఏమిటో నా భాష్మికి అర్థమవుతుందో లేదో పిచ్చోళ్ళగా ప్రతి సాయంత్రం ఇలాగే మాట్లాడుతూ ఉంటాను నేను. మీలో ఎంతమందికి మీ పర్సులో డబ్బులు ఉండాలని కోరుతున్నారో చేయి చూపించండి. చూపిస్తారా? లేదు. మీలో ఎంతమంది నా పర్సు ఎప్పుడూ ఖాళీగా ఉండాలని ఆశపడుతున్నాను అన్నవారు చేయి చూపించండి. సరే, గోడ మీద పిల్లులు ఎంతమందో చేయి చూపించండి. అటు కాదు ఇటు కాదు, మధ్యలో ఉంటారు ఎప్పుడు కూడా. దానికి ఎస్ అంటారు, దీనికి ఎస్ అంటారు. ఇన్ మై లైఫ్ ఐ లెర్న్డ్ వన్ థింగ్, వెన్ మై వాలెట్ ఈజ్ ఎంప్టీ I am mostly happy person. When my wallet is empty, you know what I do? I smile. I laugh. I feel happy when my pocket is empty. When my wallet is empty. Why is that? Something wrong with me? No. When my pocket is full, when my wallet is full, I'm not happy. Do you know why? A full wallet has only one choice, to become empty. But empty wallet has only one choice, to become full. Now you tell me, what is better? Having a wallet with full of money and finally become empty? Or having an empty wallet but then have a hope that it will become full? What is the best thing? Coming from full to empty is better, or becoming full from empty is better? What do you think about this? Look at Naomi. She went full and she became empty. But thank God, our God is a God who fills empty vessels. Our God is a wonderful God who will overflow empty vessels. Look at the prodigal son. He went away from his father bountiful. He went away from father plentiful. He took all the property that belongs to him. He was full when he went away from father. But do you know how he came back to the father? He came back to father empty. But here is the goodness about God. When Naomi came back empty, when the prodigal son came back empty, the father was willing to accept Naomi, and God, father was willing to accept the prodigal son. As I told you last time, this is a story of prodigal family. Now we are reading about a prodigal wife, a prodigal mother-in-law. She came back empty. But the unfortunate thing is, she was blaming God for her emptiness. Let us read further and see what it says. Don't call me Naomi, but call me Mara, because the Almighty has made my life very bitter. I went away full, but the Lord has brought me back empty. Why call me Naomi? The Lord has afflicted me. The Almighty has brought misfortune upon me. Four times she blamed God. So unfortunate. She is not speaking truth. Whatever she said is a lie. Why is she telling those lies? Why Naomi is unable to speak the truth? Why her language is not acceptable? Do you know why? Because she lived more than 10 years away from God. If you are living away from God, let me tell you, brothers and sisters, you can't speak properly. If you are living away from God, you cannot speak the truth. If you are living away from God, you will speak all lies. Those who tell lies, you are proving it, that your life is away from God. Who cannot speak truth, they are proving it, that their lives are away from God. Four times she blamed God. Is there anybody this evening that you are blaming God for your failures? Don't blame God. Whatever bad time you are going through, whatever tough time you are going through, whatever bad situation you are going through, it is not because of God. It is just because of you, you alone. But look what Naomi says. Don't call me Naomi. Don't call me pleasant. Call me Mara. Call me bitter. My life turned to be a bitter, bitter life. My life is full of bitter experiences. Few years back, I lost my husband. A bitter experience. After some time, I lost my elder son. A bitter experience. After that, even I lost my younger son. It's a bitter experience. Naomi says, my life is full of bitterness or bitter experiences. Why, Naomi? Why you have to go through all those bitter experiences? It is because of wrong decisions that she took, that she allowed her husband to take, or it's because of entire family's decision. But I would like to request you, dear sisters and dear brothers, don't wait until you lose everything. Don't wait to repent of your sin until you lost everything and you lose everyone in your life. Come back to God. You may ask me a question, what happens if I come back to God? What will this God do if I come back to God? Let me tell you this. The Bible was written by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit God, He mentioned about Naomi as Naomi only. When you read the 19th verse and the 20th verse and the 18th verse, God addressed Naomi. Naomi herself is saying, my life is bitter. But then God says, you are Naomi. In my sight, you are Naomi. What does it mean by that? When Naomi says, don't call me Naomi, I am not Naomi, I am Mara. But then God says, you are Naomi and Naomi and will be Naomi. What does it mean by that? God says, Naomi, you are thinking your life is bitter, but I am still thinking that your life will be better if you trust me. You are still thinking that you can never come from that bitter experience to the better experience. But let me tell you, Naomi, you are Naomi in my sight. You'll have better days. You will live in pleasant situation, pleasant condition. You will be a pleasant person. I want you to be a pleasant person. I don't want you to be a bitter person. Naomi, in my sight, I still see you as a better person. I want to see you as a better person. That's the reason why I'm calling you Naomi. This evening, dear brothers and sisters, if you have gone too far from God, and if your life begin turn to be a bitter and going through bitter experiences, and you may think that I lost everything, I lost everyone, there is no future for me, and what will God does in this situation? Let me tell you, even in that situation, God can make your life pleasant. God can make your life beautiful. God can turn your bitter experiences into better experiences. God can turn your bitter life into better life. How can I say this? Because I read this book. Because I read the book of Ruth. However, she blamed God from second chapter till fourth chapter, we see that Naomi's life turned from bitter to a better life. Why? She came back to God. Why? She came back to her senses. Why? She turned to God. If God could turn a bitter person, a better person, best person, He can do the same thing in your life. Are you going through bitter experiences? Or you turn to be a bitter person? Trust God. Look unto God. He wants to make bitter, better, and best. Let's pray. Dear brothers and sisters, going through bitter experiences and turn to be a bitter person, but still there is a hope. Still there is hope. God is willing to make your life a better, and if allow Him, even He can make you a best person. She was not a best mother-in-law in the beginning, but I can say she became best mother-in-law at the end. A bitter person became best person. If God could do it in the life of Naomi, He can do it in your life also. చేదు అనుభవం గుండా వెళుతున్న వ్యక్తికి దేవుడు మధురమైన జీవితాన్ని ఇచ్చాడు. నీ జీవితంలో కూడా అలా చేయగలడు. చేయాల్సిందల్లా నయోమి వలె నీ జీవితాన్ని దేవునికి అంకితం చేయి. ఆలస్యం చేయొద్దయ్యా. ఆలస్యము నయోమి జీవితంలో నష్టాన్ని తీసుకొచ్చింది. తన జీవితాన్ని ఖాళీ చేసి పడేసింది. భర్తను పోగొట్టుకుంది. బుద్ధి తెచ్చుకుంటే బాగుండేది. బుద్ధి తెచ్చుకోలా పెద్ద కుమారుని పోగొట్టుకుంది. బుద్ధి తెచ్చుకోలా చిన్న కుమారుని పోగొట్టుకుంది. అన్నీ పోగొట్టుకుంది. బ్రతుకు బహు బహు చేదుగా మారిపోయింది. అప్పుడు దాకా వెయిట్ చేస్తావా? లేకపోతే దేవుని సన్నిధికి వచ్చినటువంటి నయోమిని ఒక అద్భుతమైన అత్తగా దేవుడు మార్చాడు. ధన్యజీవిగా దేవుడు మార్చాడు. రాబోయే రోజుల్లో అది మనం నేర్చుకోబోతున్నాం. కానీ ఈరోజు బెటర్ లైఫ్ని బెటర్గా బెస్ట్గా మార్చే దేవుడు ఉన్నాడు. ఆయనకు ఒక అవకాశం ఇస్తావా? అవునన్నవారు మీ హస్తాన్ని ప్రభువు చూపిస్తారా? Gracious and Heavenly Father, we thank You, Lord, for what You have done in the life of Naomi and Ruth. You turned a bitter person into better and best person. That's only possible through You. There are many people praying unto You, asking You, Lord, I am a bitter person, going through bitter experiences. If You could turn Naomi's life from bitter to better and best, even I am willing to surrender my life into Your hands. I feel that my situation is helpless, hopeless, and yet I trust You, Lord. Turn my life from bitter to better and best. As many as they pray this prayer, Father God, answer them, accept them.
turn their bitter life into better and best. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. దేవుడు ఈరోజు మాతో